Well, the last time that Miss Victoria Henley joined us here on Wake Up Wiregrass, she was wearing her entrepreneur's hat as a co-owner of Colquitt, Georgia's Vicky Lynn Pecans. This morning, she's not only wearing her fashion model hat, but she's wearing her mask. We're keeping our good social distancing. And as you'll notice, an evening gown.
Yes.
Because she's here as a model today, and you've got a little different subject matter for us today.
Yes.
First of all, tell us a little bit about your background.
Yeah, of course. Thank you so much for having us back. We're so excited to be here. So, yeah, I'm from the show America's Next Top Model, and I am a host for iHeartRadio. So the fashion industry is something that I've been working in for many, many years. And today, you know, with this pandemic going on, I think a lot of people haven't really known how to handle it. Proms have been canceled, homecomings, formal events, balls, soirees, but you can still look your best and dress your best. So I am here today wearing Empire, which is a Georgia-based clothing company. They have Claire's Collection, Sherry Hill, Tony Bowles. My design partner, Sake Clothing of Denver, Colorado, makes these little bejeweled fashion masks. So virtual event, there you go. Here's some great fashion ideas for you.
Okay, now who have you brought with us this morning? Wearing something else lovely?
Yes, she is. This is our model, Reagan McLean. She's actually a local Dothan model. So she's trained with Rare Quality, and she will be modeling at our August 29th Pigeon Forge, Tennessee fashion show. So you're going to see Reagan on the runway for about 16 designers, quick changing, strutting her stuff. She's wearing a gorgeous dress from Empire in Georgia as well, and a Sarah 8 custom mask.
All righty. Well, she's looking lovely, as are you. Now, you know, I know that in your business, Magnifique.
Magnifique, yes.
You are in the business of also looking for models. Tell us about what you look for and what how people can go about applying to be a model such as you and Reagan.
Absolutely. You know, I started modeling with my cousin, who was a Ford model, when I was about 8 years old, and I drove twice. Well, my mom drove me twice a week to take lessons with her. So one goal after I did America's Next Top Model, I want to turn around and help the next people that are wanting to kind of get into the foray of modeling. So we're always looking for different models of all ages, shapes, and sizes. Don't be shy. If you are on Instagram, I'm at Victoria Henley. You can always direct message us there. On Facebook, it's JTV Victoria. And I'm sure if you have our email, you'll air that. But we're always looking for models. August 29th in Tennessee is actually our first, and it's going to be a big event at the Black Fox Resort and Convention Center. And we have some shoots going on at Portofino Island Resort in Florida. We know everybody's ready to get out and do something. Everybody's stir crazy. So we're distancing, but we're still going to have a great fashion forward time.
Okay, great. So there's the address to reach Victoria, magnifiquerunway@gmail.com for any and all sizes, shapes, ages, ethnic, whatever, right?
That's the great thing, you know, especially in these times, and there's a lot of polarizing, there's a lot of diversity, but in our shows, diversity is very important. So all ages, all genders. Our oldest model that we had at New York Fashion Week was 75 years old, and our youngest model we're going to have, this one is about 10 months old. And you see all, you see everything, you know, you see all ethnicities, all backgrounds, because fashion is for everyone, and we really, truly do believe that. So if you're interested in modeling, we want to hear from you. If you're a designer, you have a clothing label, we want to hear from you. We are all about that inclusivity.
Oh, that's wonderful. What a modeling has changed over the years.
It has. Okay. It absolutely
Thank
has.
You, Victoria and Reagan,
Thank
for joining
so
us this morning. Coming up next, Election Day difficulties during Georgia's primary and billionaire Mark Cuban's optimistic view about future business in America. We'll be right back. Stay with us.